हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर रोहित गुप्ता, ऑथर ऑफ न्यू रिवाइज्ड एंड अपडेटेड एडिशन ऑफ एलएनएस की नोट की नोट्स एडवांस एंड कंप्लीट व्हिच इज अवेलेबल ऑनलाइन एट amazon.in एंड ऑफलाइन एट 9559096477। द फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस न्यू सीरीज इज इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशनल स्किल ऑफ फिजिशियन इन होम्योपैथिक प्रैक्टिस। बट बिफोर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन इट, फर्स्ट वी शुड गो टू इट्स हिस्ट्री एंड ओरिजिन इन मेडिकल साइंस विद रिलेशन टू होम्योपैथी।
To fully understand this series, watch this video till the end without skipping or forwarding it, so that you would not have any problem in understanding of any video in future. Now the first topic of this series, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. At first, we must know what was the eligibility of stalwarts and the founder of homeopathy. After shortlisting of 20 renowned stalwarts along with founder of homeopathy, Dr. C.F.S. Hahnemann, the figure showed that 90% of those were in the qualification of physician, means medicos, and the remaining 10% of them were non-medicos. Most of them were allopath, surgeon, and homeopath, and they were following inductive method guided by Dr. Hahnemann. In The Genius of Homeopathy, Stuart Close said, analysis of the organon of Hahnemann as well as of the history of homeopathy and the life of its founder shows clearly that homeopathy is a product of inductive logic applied to the subject of medicine. It is in fact the first as well as one of the most brilliant examples of the application of the inductive method to the solution of one of the greatest problem of humanity, namely the treatment and cure of disease. But today we are following method of a non-medico blindly called deductive method without knowing history of his exact qualification. There is no doubt that he had also contributed in homeopathy, but changing the method from induction to deduction without complete knowledge of medical science caused so much damage to basics of homeopathy by distracting homeopaths from the right path. That's why medico stalwarts have used clinical and diagnostic medical terms and symptoms in their materia medica, whereas non-medico has used mental and repertorial approach, etc. Because of which we still stand 176 years back at 1814-3, when the last 6th edition of Organon of Medicine was completed even after guidance of Dr. Hahnemann. Modern medical science called allopathy had adopted and upgraded themselves and made largely acceptable so that it came into mainstream. But homeopaths have misinterpreted same thing in the Organon of Medicine and its philosophy with rigid and conservative culture of teaching that led to mushrooming of many new self-made methods in homeopathy. Dr. Hahnemann's inductive method in science is the application of the principle of inductive logic to scientific research. Inductive method leads complete symptoms in case taking. It requires exact observation, correct interpretation, rational explanation, and scientific construction. According to homeopathy, there are two types of observation, clinical and simulimum. Clinical also have two subtypes, signs and symptoms, whereas simulimum contains characteristic rare and peculiar symptoms. General definition of observation: the action or process of closely observing or monitoring something or someone, or the active acquisition of information from a primary source. In living beings, observation employs the senses. In science, observation can also involve the recording of data via the use of scientific instrument. In living beings, observation in philosophical terms is the process of filtering sensory information through the thought process, and input is received via hearing, sight, smell, taste, and touch, and then analyzed through either rational or irrational thought. In science, according to definition of Organon of Medicine, an instrument for acquiring knowledge, is specifically a body of principles of scientific or philosophical investigation. Where does Dr. Hahnemann write about it in his book Organon of Medicine? I will tell the reference in the middle of the topic in all videos of this series. In aphorism 6, he mentioned, all these perceptible signs represent the disease in its whole extent, that is, together they form the true and only conceivable portrait of the disease. It means all the perceptible signs and symptoms of disease represent the disease in its entirety. In diagnosis of disease, according to aphorism 14, he mentioned the accurately observing physicians by means of morbid signs and symptoms, an arrangement in perfect conformity with the infinite goodness of the well-wise preserver of human life. It means everything curably diseased makes itself known to that physician by signs and symptoms. Now, what signs and symptoms mean? Signs and symptoms are abnormalities that can indicate a potential medical condition, whereas a symptom is subjective, that is apparent only to the patient, for example, pain, fatigue, burning, etc. A sign is any objective evidence of disease that can be observed by other than patient, for example, a skin rash, lump, enlarged lymph nodes, abnormal pulse and temperature, etc. A clinical examination or medical examination or physical examination is the process by which a medical practitioner examines the body of a patient for any possible signs or symptoms of a medical condition through the use of observation by inspection, palpation, percussion, auscultation, etc. Note, the physical examination should yield 20% of the data necessary for patient diagnosis and management. In clinical examination, as currently used, was developed in the early 19th century as a method to evaluate symptoms in relation to recognized pathologies in order to facilitate diagnosis, management and treatment. Before the 19th century, the history and physical examination were nearly the only diagnostic tools the physician had, which explains why tactile skill and ingenious appreciation in the exam were so highly valued in the definition of what made for a good physician. Before 1895, the world had no radiography, but in 1879, C. Herring had mentioned hydrothorax, meteorism and tympanitis like medical words in his 10 volume of book Herring Guiding Symptoms before invention of radiography. And Dr. S.C. Allen had also mentioned same medical terminology in his last second edition of book Keynotes and Characteristics after clinical verification in 1899, which also called Allen's Keynote. Indeed, people expect their doctor to examine them as a part of medical consultation. But after recommendation of Dr. Hahnemann in Organon of Medicine, it is the biggest mistake of homeopath is that many people do not think as doctor. So the physical examination is a time-honored technique in medical practice, and method of medical examination are described in Egyptian papyri, in the classical world of ancient Greece and Rome, and in Vedic medicine in India. Now, observation by physician through all his five senses according to allied subjects and Materia Medica. Abnormal pulse, abnormal temperature, enlargement of lymph nodes, enlargement of abdominal viscera, sensitiveness of disease part, tenderness, edema, etc. by touch, cough, chest, pulmonary sound, heart sound, voice, etc. by hearing, taste of mouth and irritation by patient in taste, odor of breath, diseased part, discharge, etc. by smell, gesture and appearance, anemia, jaundice, carotid vein, abnormal gait, cyanosis, pigmentation, hemorrhagic spot, tremor, clubbing, some diseases, etc. by sight. And now I will tell the observation related to touch of physician by temperature and pulse. Here you can see some underlined symptoms, violet in color, which are signs and symptoms of the disease septicemia for diagnosis and treatment, which are written in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advanced and complete. Chill, severe, general of bones and extremities, marking onset of septic fever, temperature 103 to 106, pulse rapid, small, wiry 140 to 170, cold clammy sweat in pyrogen. Similarly, the diagnosis of arrhythmia through signs and symptoms of pulse, full, irregular, very slow and weak, intermitting every third, fifth or seventh beat in diastolic. The diagnosis of cervical tubercular lymphadenopathy through signs and symptoms of stony heart, scrofulous or tubercular swelling of glands, especially lower jaw and throat in bromium. The diagnosis of hepatomegaly through signs and symptoms of pressing pain in liver, liver heart enlarged, aggravation by lying on right side in magmur. In sensitiveness of diseased part, extreme sensitiveness to touch in apis, belladonna and lachesis. The diagnosis of bowel obstruction or peritonitis through signs and symptoms of abdomen tender, distended, aggravation by least jar even of the bed in belladonna. Similarly, the diagnosis of pitting edema through signs and symptoms of dropsy from organic heart disease, from chronic liver disease, for advanced albuminuria following intermittent fever in leg diaphoretum. Similarly, the diagnosis of non-pitting edema, dropsy of lower extremities through signs and symptoms of edematous swelling in various parts of body, especially in legs, instep and feet in Sambucus nigra. Single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advanced and complete. For example, I am sharing a case of my mother when she was suffering from non-pitting edema in both lower limbs, diagnosed by a super specialist allopathic physician. After clinical examination and he advised some important and related investigation like 2D echo of heart, USG of abdomen, fibroscan, chest X-ray, KFT and thyroid profile with his medicinal treatment. But when there was no any improvement of that medication, I have given her Sambucus 30, then 200, after then 1 mL with drastic improvement on the basis of the clinical indication, edematous swelling in various parts of the body, especially in legs, instep and feet. My objective is not to discredit any pathy or its physician. My objective is just to aware about the work limits of both pathy and where to take medical treatment. Thank you.
Second part of first topic, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. According to modern medical science and allied subjects, appropriate skills are needed to elicit the symptoms from the patient's description and clinical examinations. But new medical students and practitioners usually feel that history taking out to be fairly simple, but clinical examination is full of pitfalls.
Importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice, part 2. This part is continuation of the previous part, and if you have not seen the last part, then link has been given below in the detail. Dr. Hahnemann has mentioned about the knowledge of disease indication in aphorism 3, qualification of physician in Organon of Medicine. This is the most important aphorism of the Organon of Medicine, in which Dr. Hahnemann had mentioned that what qualifications physician must have for doing successful homeopathic practice in classical way. Dr. Hahnemann said in aphorism 3, if the physician clearly perceives what is to be cured in diseases, that is to say, in every individual case of disease, knowledge of disease indication. It means physician must investigate what is to be cured in disease, knowledge of disease indication. And in aphorism 71, he said, how is the physician to ascertain what is necessary to be known in order to cure the disease? It means in the 3 point necessary for curing, first is investigation of the disease. Now I will tell the observation related to the rest 4 senses of physician except touch, which are already discussed in last video. By sense of hearing, here you can see some underlined symptoms violet in color, which are signs and symptoms of disease. Paroxysmal cough. Cough paroxysms of 3 in sternumate and of 2 in mucous. Similarly, the diagnosis of laryngotracheobronchitis through signs and symptoms of croup, anxious wheezing, aggravation during inspiration in spongia. The diagnosis of systolic murmur through signs and symptoms of systolic blowing at apex in spige area. The diagnosis of stammering through signs and symptoms of stammering or has to exert himself a long time before he can utter a word or makes great effort to speak in stramonium. Next is by sense of taste of the patient. In condition of dry mouth, signs and symptoms are bad taste in the morning in pulsatilla. The diagnosis of GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease, or acid reflux through signs and symptoms of eructations, sour, bitter after eating in nux vomica. Next is by sense of smell. The diagnosis of CA mouth through signs and symptoms of malignant affections of mouth, offensive foul breath in muriatic acid. In condition of infected wound, signs and symptoms are wounds old neglected offensive in calendula. The diagnosis of otitis media or perforated eardrum or excessive earwax through signs and symptoms of fish brain discharge from ear in tellurium. Next is by sense of sight. The diagnosis of anemia through signs and symptoms of red parts become white, face, lips, tongue and mucous membrane of mouth. The diagnosis of jaundice through signs and symptoms of fever, conjunctiva yellow or orange color in laryngeal. The diagnosis of high blood pressure, palpitation with pulsation of carotid veins through signs and symptoms of violent palpitation with throbbing in carotids in glenoid. Similarly, the diagnosis of ataxia through signs and symptoms of lack of muscular coordination, muscles refuse to obey the will in gelsemium. The diagnosis of cyanosis through signs and symptoms of blueness of skin, eyelids, lips, tongue, cyanosis in distalis. Diagnosis of syphilis through signs and symptoms of eruption, dull red copper colored spots in syphilinum. The diagnosis purpura through signs and symptoms of petechia purpura hemorrhagica, blue spots in sulfuric acid. Similarly, the diagnosis of neurocysticercosis through signs and symptoms of nervous diseases, twitching, convulsive trembling, catalepsy from worms in sabadilla. This is single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advance and complete. The diagnosis of Parkinson's disease through signs and symptoms of marked facial expression, short stepped gait, trembling of extremities, etc. as paralysis agitans in mucous. This is also single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advanced and complete. Paralysis agitans is the old medical terminology of Parkinson's disease, and like this there are many old difficult medical terminology explained in dictionary part of this book. You can see here on right side. Similarly, the diagnosis of senile decrepitude through signs and symptoms of hearing, smell and sight begin to fail in embriagracia. This is also single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advanced and complete. You can see here there are many underlined symptoms on right side. These symptoms are Dr. H.C. Allen's last work, which was published after his death but not included in current Allen's keynote. All these updates you can find only in this book. Thank you.
I am going to discuss on third part of first topic, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. During painful conditions, some special gesture of the patient have a classic site of pain and radiation, which guide us for diagnosis and their proper treatment, as well as the physical examination during observation of any consultation. The non-verbal communication is as important as what the patient says.
Importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice, part 3. This part is the continuation of the previous two part of this series. In aphorism 83, Dr. Hahnemann said, "This individualizing examination of a case of disease, for which I shall only give in this place general directions, of which the practitioner will bear in mind only what is applicable for each individual case, demands of the physician nothing but freedom from prejudice and sound senses, attention in observing and fidelity in tracing the picture of the disease. It means necessary for apprehending the picture of the disease. In considering the patient's general appearance, it is important to make a rapid assessment of the degree of illness. A history of weight gain or loss can be checked by observation, remembering that fluid retention will increase weight through edema. Obvious weight loss even when food intake has increased is a feature of thyrotoxicosis and diabetes mellitus. But psychogenic loss of appetite, usually affecting girls, causes extreme emaciation, while physical activity remains unimpaired in anorexia nervosa. Through facial appearance, physician must need to observe the patient's face, the expression and particularly the eyes indicate real feelings better than words. The cheeks give information regarding the patient's health. They are pale in anemia and hypopituitarism. Generalized pallor may also occur in severe anemia. In case of mitral stenosis, there is sometimes a bright circumscribed flush over the malar bones, and in congestive heart failure, they may also be highly colored. In some cases of systemic lupus erythematosus, there is a red raised eruption on the bridge of the nose that extend on to the cheeks in a butterfly distribution. Telangiectasia, minute capillary tortuosity or navy, may be seen on the face in chronic liver disease. Cyanosis is a bluish color of the skin and mucous membrane on lips and tongue, owing to the presence of reduced hemoglobin in the blood, feature of COPD or congestive heart disease. In atrophic glossitis, complete atrophy of lingual papillae seen in pernicious anemia or iron deficiency anemia. Now through color of skin, the pigmentation of Addison disease affect the buccal mucous membranes as well as exposed skin and parts subject to friction. In von Recklinghausen's disease, patches of cafe outlet pigment freckling of the axillae to large more than 5 cm in length areas on the limbs, trunk or face are a characteristic feature. By the observation of the hands of the patient, some classic appearance that should always be sought include finger clubbing in malignant diseases. Nail bed splinter hemorrhage. Most common cause is trauma to the nails. Chorionychia, which occurs in long-standing iron deficiency anemia. Tremor should be assessed carefully, distinguishing between a rapid fine tremor due to thyrotoxicosis and flapping tremor of metabolic encephalopathy due to hepatic or renal or respiratory failure. Now through physical attitude of the patient. Severely ill patients slip down the bed or chair into uncomfortable attitudes. They are unable to correct in muriatic acid in new edition of Allen's keynote, Keynotes Advance and Complete. Patients with heart failure sit up because they may become dyspneic if they lie flat due to orthopnea. Patient with abdominal pain due to peritonitis lie still, whereas patient with colic are restless or may even roll about in futile attempt to find relief. Patient with painful joint diseases often have an attitude of helplessness like arthritis or rheumatoid arthritis or osteoarthritis. Now through the odor of the patient. The odor of alcohol is easily recognized in the breath, although patient may try and mask it in alcohol intoxication. The odor of sweet and sickly has been found in diabetic ketosis. The odor of ammonical or fishy is found in uremia, chronic kidney diseases. The odor of mousy in hepatic failure. Halitosis means bad breath is common in those patients whose poor dental hygiene and associated with chronic gingivitis. Now, particular gesture useful analyzing specific pain symptoms. Headache accompanied by preceding flashing lights, nausea and vomiting suggest migraine. A squeezing gesture to describe cardiac pain. Pain with hand position to describe renal colic. Rubbing the sternum to describe heartburn. Rubbing the buttock and thigh to describe sciatica. Arms clenched around the abdomen to describe midgut colic. Pain of subarachnoid hemorrhage is classically very sudden, like a hammer blow on the head. Myocardial ischemia is classically felt in the center of the chest. Peptic ulcer pain is classically worse when hungry and better after food. Pain from a hollow organ is classically colicky, such as biliary or renal or intestinal. Colicky right upper quadrant abdominal pain accompanied by obstructive jaundice suggests a gallstone obstructing the bile duct. Thank you.
On fourth part of first topic, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathy practice. A physical examination on clinical as well as homeopathic point of view requires a cooperative patient. Daylight is better than artificial light, which may mask changes in skin and mucous membrane color. Remember that physical examination starts from the moment you meet the patient during consultation. Every moment of your contact with the patient, every gesture and every communication is full of information.
Importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice, part 4. In aphorism 104, Dr. Hahnemann said, when the totality of the symptoms that especially mark and distinguish the case of disease, or in other words, when the picture of the disease, whatever be its kind, is once accurately sketched, the most difficult part of the task is accomplished. It means utility of the picture of disease for the purpose of curing and progress of the treatment. According to homeopathy, there are two types of observation. First is clinical, which has already discussed in last three part of this series, and second is simulum, which also contain two subtype. First is characteristic sign and second is characteristic symptoms. In aphorism 146 to 203, homeopathic treatment of disease part of Organon of Medicine, and in aphorism 153, Dr. Hahnemann said, in this search for a homeopathic specific remedy, that is to say, in this comparison of the collective symptoms of the natural disease with the list of symptoms of known medicines, in order to find among these an artificial morphic agent corresponding by similarity to the disease to be cured, the most striking, singular, uncommon and peculiar characteristic signs and symptoms of the case of disease are chiefly and most solely to be kept in view. Now, selection of remedies on the basis of expression, appearance and constitutional physical makeup of the patient. Expression by sight. The countenance is expressive of fear in Aconitum napellus. Adapted to women of thin, scrawny, feeble, cachectic appearance in Sickle cornutum. Appearance by sight. Tongue white or yellow with red streak down the middle, or dry, moist, white or yellow coating or no coating on either side. Feels scalded in Veratrum viridi. Constitutional physical makeup by sight. Body large and fat but legs too thin in Ammonium muriaticum. Better adapted to thin and emaciated than to fleshy persons in Lachesis. Some examples on selection of remedies by all five senses of physician. By sight, swallow with deep furrows looks older than he is in Lycopodium. A yellow saddle across the upper part of the cheeks and nose in Sepia. Children emaciated, unable to stand, slow in learning to walk, sunken flabby abdomen in Calcarea phosphorica. Weakness and trembling of tongue, hands, legs of the entire body in Gelsemium. Causes redness of face and eyes in Belladonna. Now by smell, the urine has the odor of violets in Terebinth. Wounds old, neglected, offensive in Calendula. By hearing, sleep with stertorous breath in Opium. Stammering makes great effort to speak in Stramonium. Now by taste of the patient, irritation sour bitter in Nux Vomica. Heartburn sour belching, irritation taste and vomiting in Macarb. Now by touch. Parts cold to touch but not cold subjectively to patient in Lidampal. Heat of upper part of body, coldness of lower in Arnica Montana. Thank you.
Correct interpretation is as important as observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice for exact understanding of the cases. In correct interpretation, the observed facts needs analysis with understanding them in relation to each other and to their cause.
Importance of correct interpretation in homeopathic practice. Inductive method leads complete symptoms in case taking. It requires exact observation, correct interpretation, rational explanation and scientific construction means anamnesis. I have already discussed on its previous part, exact observation, in fourth part of video. Now I am going to on its second part, correct interpretation. Correct interpretation means understanding of observed facts with relation to each other and to their cause. Correct interpretation contains three part: cause, complaint and concomitant. According to cause, in introduction chapter of the Organon of Medicine, Dr. Hahnemann steps into say, for the first time in all history, remove the effects and you remove the disease, the cause of the effects, as written as ceased effectus, ceased causa. Cause is just like a trauma to the body which makes it ill after effect. It can be of many types, like environmental, physical, mental or any severe disease itself, etc. Now example of environmental cause. You can see a violet color box marked in Brania alba medicine. Complaints: warm weather sets in after cold age, or from cold drinks or ice sets in hot weather, or after taking cold or getting hot in summer, or from chilling when overheated kicks the covers off, or from exposure to draft cold wind, also present in aconite and hypersulf. Second example of physical, written in Arnica montana in violet color box. For the bad effects resulting from mechanical injuries, even if received years ago, and especially adapted to those who remain long impressed by even slight mechanical injuries. And mechanical injuries, especially with stupor from concussion, involuntary feces and urine, and after injuries with blunt instruments, also present in symphytum, and compound fractures and their profuse suppuration, also present in calendula, and concussions and contusions, results of shock or injury without laceration of sharp parts, prevent suppuration and septic conditions and promote absorption. Third example of mental, in Brania alba again, elements from chagrin, mortification, anger, also present in colocynth and staphylococcygia, violence with chillness and coldness, after anger chilly but with head hot and face red, also present in aurum mate. Fourth is example of any severe disease. In Carbo vegetabilis, you can see persons who have never fully recovered from the exhausting effects of some previous illness, or asthma dates from measles or pertussis of childhood, and has never recovered from effects of typhoid, also present in psoriasis. Now second part after cause is complaint. Complaint is nothing but a disease of the human body. It may be acute or chronic or artificial chronic in nature, and every disease has its own sign and symptom for exact diagnosis, with concomitant symptoms for selection of similar remedy. For example, in Distalis purpuree, you can see here a violet color box with symptom: stools, very light ash colored or delayed chalky, also present in Chelidonium and Podophyllum, or almost white, also present in Calcarea and Cinchona, or pipe stem stool, involuntary. And all these symptoms are the feature of obstructive jaundice. Now concomitant, third part. The uncommon, rare, peculiar, characteristic symptom is known as concomitant symptoms. It can be pathological condition, physical, mental, modality and cause of the disease. Now we are going to step by step, one after another. Now first, pathological concomitant. In Chelidonium majus, you can see violet color box with symptoms: constant pain under the lower and inner angle of right scapula, and some underlying violet color symptoms: slimy, light gray or bright yellowish diarrhea, फेस, फोरहेड, नोज, चीक्स रिमार्केबली येलो, येलो ग्रे कलर ऑफ द स्किन, विल्टेड स्किन ऑफ द पॉम्स ऑफ हैंड्स ऑल्सो अवेलेबल इन सीपिया, हिपेटिक डिजीजेज, जॉइंटिस, पेन इन राइट शोल्डर. ऑल दिस सिम्टम्स आर द फीचर ऑफ पेनफुल ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिव जॉइंटिस एंड द बॉक्स विथ सिम्टम आर द कॉन्कोमिटेंट पैथोलॉजिकल कंडीशन. सेकेंड इज फिजिकल कॉन्कोमिटेंट. इन एंटीमोनियम क्रूडम अ थिक मिल्की वाइट कोटिंग ऑन द टंग विच इज द रेड स्टैंड ऑफ द रेमेडी एंड लॉन्गिंग फॉर एसिड्स एंड पिकल्स ऑल्सो. नाउ थर्ड इज मेंटल कॉन्कोमिटेंट. इन पल्सेटिला वीप्स इजली, ऑलमोस्ट इम्पॉसिबल टू डिटेल हर एलिमेंट्स विदाउट वीपिंग एंड वीप्स वेन थैंक्ड इन लाइकोपोडियम. नाउ फोर्थ इज मॉडलिटी कॉन्कोमिटेंट. इन ब्रानिया अल्बा वन ऑफ द चीफ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ब्रानिया इज एग्रावेशन फ्रॉम एनी मोशन एंड करस्पॉन्डिंग रिलीफ फ्रॉम एब्सोल्यूट रेस्ट आइदर मेंटल और फिजिकल. एंड फिफ्थ कॉन्कोमिटेंट ऑफ कॉज ऑफ द डिजीज. इन सिनकोना एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम लॉस ऑफ वाइटल फ्लूइड्स स्पेशली हेमरेजेज, एक्सेसिव लैक्टेशन, डायरिया और सपुरेशन ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन चिनियम सेल्फ. नाउ करेक्ट इंटरप्रिटेशन इज मेड ऑफ टू पार्ट, पैथोलॉजिकल एंड फिलोसफिकल. इन पैथोलॉजिकल कंडीशन इफ द इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द पैथोलॉजी विल नॉट बी करेक्ट, डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द डिजीज विल ऑल्सो नॉट बी परफेक्ट विच इज नेसेसरी फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ प्रोग्नोसिस एंड केस मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द डिजीज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन हाइपरट्रॉफी ऑफ हार्ट, an increase in size and weight of the myocardium results from increased pressure load, while increased volume load due to most common cause of valvular incompetence. You can see here on right side the causes of the hypertrophy in left ventricular hypertrophy and right ventricular hypertrophy. Here you can see some underlying cause and the most common cause are valvular diseases. In left ventricular hypertrophy, aortic stenosis and insufficiency, mitral insufficiency. And in right ventricular hypertrophy, pulmonary stenosis and insufficiency, mitral stenosis and or insufficiency. And left ventricular hypertrophy and failure of the left ventricle also related to each other. And the medicine for this condition is nasotripudence, simple hypertrophy of heart for restoring a heart damage by acute inflammation or from relief of suffering of chronic hypertrophy and valvular lesions. Now second is philosophical. Similarly, if the interpretation of theory is not correct, then the right direction of treatment does not get in any case, because each case has variation in approach due to different angle of perception according to inductive method of Dr. Hahnemann. For example, in Medorhinum, for the constitutional effects of maltreated and suppressed gonorrhea when the best selected remedy fails to relieve or permanently improve. And this constitutional symptom is the part of second prescription. Thank you.
Rational explanation and correct interpretation are two sides of the same coin. In this part of series, physician must know about the facts of rational explanation by referring them to their real cause and the law of inductive method according to Dr. Hahnemann.
Importance of rational explanation or intellectual or practical explanation in homeopathic practice. Inductive method leads complete symptoms in case taking. It requires exact observation, correct interpretation, rational explanation and scientific construction, means anamnesis. Now we are going on its third part, rational explanation. Rational explanation is an explanation that is logical with a large system of thought or referring facts to their real cause or law. Classification of rational explanation One is philosophical and second is pathological. In philosophical, just like a seed of any type of plant, like disease, needs a special kind of fertile land to grow and become a tree. And that special kind of fertile land is hidden in past history of that disease. So, importance of past history according to philosophy, the fundamental principle of homeopathy, similius similibus curantur, which is a statement in equivalent terms of the Newton's third law, action and reaction are equal and opposite. It has four types: psychosomatic disorder, somatopsychic disorder, suppression of disease and chronic miasms. First is psychosomatic disorder, when mental factors cause physical symptoms. In footnote of aphorism 222 in Organon of Medicine, it has been mentioned as it very rarely happens that a mental or emotional disease of long standing seizes spontaneously, for the internal dyschasia transfers itself again to the grosser corporeal organs. For example, a chest pain might be caused by stress, palpitation of heart might be caused by anxiety, but no physical disease is found. In staphys aegria, you can see here a violet color box with some symptoms. Symptoms are: was insulted, being to be dignified, to fight, subdued his wrath, and went home sick, trembling and exhausted. It had been mentioned in new edition of Allen's keynote, Keynotes Advanced and Complete. Now, second is somatopsychic disorder, when mental symptoms caused by bodily illness. In aphorism 224 in Organon of Medicine, it has been mentioned that if the mental disease be not quite developed, and if it be still somewhat doubtful whether it really arose from a corporeal affection. For example, altered mental functioning is a basic feature of myotonic dystrophy. And you can see in opium medicine, suppression of discharges like stool, urine, etc. causes encephalopathic condition. You can see here many symptoms are underlined with violet color, like all complaints with great sopor. Sopor is a Spanish word which means abnormally deep sleep. You can say it as coma. And next is sleep heavy, stupid, or with stertorous breathing, red face, eyes half closed, bloodshot, or skin covered with hot sweat, or after convulsions. Next is digestive organ inactive, peristaltic motion reversed or paralyzed, bowel seems closed. Again, next is constipation from inaction or paresis, no desire, urine retained with bladder full, paralysis of bladder or sphincter. And in opium, the secretion is not diminished, the bladder is full, but fullness is unrecognized. All these symptoms are related to each other in encephalopathic condition. Now, third is suppression of disease, the development of secondary disease condition from suppressed condition of previous illness. The reference are mentioned in Organon of Medicine in preface 4th paragraph, in footnote 25th of introduction, aphorism 39, and in footnote of aphorism 285. For example, in Rastak, the dermatitis should never be treated by topical medicated applications. They only suppress, never cure. And fourth is chronic miasm. In aphorism 204 and 205 in Organon of Medicine, it has been mentioned as all chronic affections and diseases, properly so called, must be cured only from within by the homeopathic medicines appropriate for the miasm that lies at their root. For example, in tuberculinum, you can see here headache, chronic tubercular, again when the best selected remedy only palliates.
नेक्स्ट इज स्कूल गर्ल्स हेडेक विद अ ट्यूबरकुलर हिस्ट्री. सो नथिंग हैपन्स विदाउट अ रीजन, इट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नेचर. नाउ सेकेंड पार्ट इज पैथोलॉजिकल. इन दिस कंडीशन चेंज ऑफ पोजिशन, स्टेट ऑफ फॉर्म और द स्प्रेड ऑफ डिजीज प्रोड्यूसिंग एजेंसी फ्रॉम द इनिशियल साइट ऑफ डिजीज टू अनदर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी, इट्स कॉल्ड मेटास्कमेटिज्म और मेटास्टेसिस. इट मे अकर एज एन एडवर्स रिएक्शन टू ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ अदर डिजीज कंडीशन कॉल्ड मेटास्टेसिस. इन फुट नोट ऑफ एफरिज्म 205 मेंशनड एज द बेसिक मेलेडी इज देयर बाई नॉट डिमिनिश्ड इन द स्लाइटेस्ट, द प्रिजर्विंग वाइटल फोर्स इज देयर फोर नेसेसिएटेड टू ट्रांसफर द फील्ड ऑफ ऑपरेशन ऑफ द ग्रेट इंटरनल मेलेडी टू सम मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट एज इट डज इन एवरी केस ऑफ मेटास्कमेटिज्म. एंड द कॉन्सिक्वेंस इज ब्लाइंडनेस, डीफनेस, इंसैनिटी, सफोकेटिव अस्थमा, ड्रॉप्सी, एपोप्लेक्सी एंड एटसेट्रा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन कोलिनसोनिया आफ्टर हर्ट इज रिलीव्ड ओल्ड पाइल्स रीअपेयर आर सप्रेस्ड मेंसेज रिटर्न. एंड इन पल्सेटिला मम्स मेटास्टेसिस टू मैमी आर टेस्टिकल. सो डिजीजेज ऑफ अननोन ओरिजिन सो कॉल्ड एडियोपैथिक हैव टू टाइप ऑफ कॉजेशन, डायरेक्ट कॉजेशन एंड इनडायरेक्ट कॉजेशन. इन डायरेक्ट कॉजेशन मेटास्केमेटिज्म, साइकोसोमेटिक डिसऑर्डर, सोमेटोसाइकिक डिसऑर्डर, सप्रेशन ऑफ डिजीज एंड इनडायरेक्ट कॉज इन क्रॉनिक मियाज आर द प्रीडोमिनेंट. नाउ इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ पास्ट हिस्ट्री अकॉर्डिंग टू पैथोलॉजी. रूमेटिक हार्ट डिजीज इज अ सीक्वल ऑफ रूमेटिक फीवर इन चाइल्डहुड एंड मार्कर फॉर इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज एसो टाइटर एंड 2D इको. नेक्स्ट इज हिस्ट्री ऑफ हेपेटाइटिस बी और सी इन्फेक्शन थ्रू ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन और इन्फेक्टेड इंजेक्शन और STD, सेक्सुअल ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीजेज और एटसेट्रा में कॉजेज क्रॉनिक लिवर डिजीज. मार्कर फॉर इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज HBsAg और NTHCV विद रेस्ड HBDNA और SCVRNA क्वांटिटेटिव. नेक्स्ट इज एब्यूज ऑफ NSAIDs में कॉज क्रॉनिक किडनी डिजीज. मार्कर फॉर इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज रेस्ट क्रिएटिनिन विथ स्कैंटी मैच्यूरेशन. नाउ एडवर्स इफेक्ट्स ऑफ वैक्सीनेशन. इन थूजा यू कैन सी हेयर एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम बैड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ वैक्सीनेशन इन ब्रैकेट एंटीमटाट एंड सिलिशिया एंड मिजोरम. ऑल्सो यू कैन सी हेयर मैनी वैक्सीन्स विद देयर एडवर्स इफेक्ट विद रेफरेंस ऑफ पार्क 20th edition. Acute flaccid paralysis adverse effect by OPV vaccine, anaphylactoid reaction by all type of vaccine, anaphylaxis by all type of vaccine, arthralgia by rubella MMR, brachial neuritis by tetanus, disseminated BCG infection by BCG vaccine, encephalopathy by measles and pertussis vaccine, fever by all type of vaccine, hypotonic hyporesponsive episode mainly by DTP vaccine, injection site abscess by all type of vaccine, lymphadenitis by BCG vaccine, osteitis or osteomyelitis by BCG vaccine, persistent inconsolable screaming by DTP and pertussis vaccine, seizures by all type of vaccines especially pertussis and measles, sepsis by all type of vaccines, adverse effects severe local reaction by all type of vaccine, thrombocytopenia by MMR vaccine and toxic shock syndrome by all type of vaccine. Thank you.
We are going to discuss on fourth and last part of this series, scientific construction. It means analysis of the case. In scientific construction, physician must put the facts in coordination that the system we shall agree with the reality and simulum choice of the remedy according to the law of inductive method. For example, which disease has occurred, in what order and after what has happened so that it can be eliminated by accessing the root of the disease.
Last and seventh part of this series, importance of scientific construction in homeopathic practice. और एनामनेसिस। इंडक्टिव मेथड लेट्स कंप्लीट सिम्टम्स इन केस टेकिंग, इट रिक्वायर्स एग्जैक्ट ऑब्जर्वेशन, करेक्ट इंटरप्रिटेशन, रैशनल एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड साइंटिफिक कंस्ट्रक्शन मीन्स एनामनेसिस। इन ऑल दीज फोर क्वालिफिकेशन ऑफ फिजिशियन यू विल ऑटोमेटिकली लर्न थ्री मोर रिक्वायर्ड क्वालिफिकेशंस विच इंक्लूड नॉलेज ऑफ डिजीज, नॉलेज ऑफ मेडिसिन एंड नॉलेज ऑफ एप्लीकेशन ऑफ मेडिसिन विच हैव बीन मेंशन इन एफरिज्म 3 इन ऑर्गनॉन ऑफ मेडिसिन। फॉर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ साइंटिफिक कंस्ट्रक्शन यू शुड रीड इट इन एफरिज्म 83-104 केस टेकिंग पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्गनॉन ऑफ मेडिसिन। द मेडिकल हिस्ट्री और केस हिस्ट्री और एनामनेसिस ऑफ अ पेशेंट इज इंफॉर्मेशन गेन्ड बाई अ फिजिशियन बाई आस्किंग क्वेश्चन आइदर ऑफ द पेशेंट और ऑफ अदर पीपुल हु नो द पर्सन एंड कैन गिव सुटेबल इंफॉर्मेशन विद द एम ऑफ ऑब्टेनिंग इंफॉर्मेशन यूजफुल इन फॉर्मुलेटिंग अ डायग्नोसिस एंड प्रोवाइडिंग मेडिकल केयर टू द पेशेंट। द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑब्टेंड इन दिस वे टूगेदर विद द क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन enables the physician to form a diagnosis and discover the remedy for constitutional treatment. The method by which doctors gather information about a patient's past and present medical condition in order to make informed clinical decision is called the history and physical. The history requires that a clinician be skilled in asking appropriate and relevant questions that can provide them with some insight as to what the patient may be experiencing. After all of the important history questions have been asked, a focused physical exam only involves what is relevant to the chief concern is usually done. Based on the information obtained from the history and physical, lab and imaging tests are ordered and medical or surgical treatment is administered as necessary. Systems are usually reviewed in a comprehensive history related to present complaint. For diseases of cardiovascular system, chest pain, dyspnea, ankle swelling and palpitation are the most important symptoms, and you can ask for a brief description for each of the positive symptoms. For disease of respiratory system, cough, hemoptysis, epistaxis, wheezing, pain localized to the chest that might increase with inspiration or expiration. For diseases of gastrointestinal system, change in weight, flatulence, heartburn, dysphagia, hematemesis, melena, hematochezia, abdominal pain, vomiting and bowel habit. For diseases of genitourinary system, you should ask about frequency in urination, pain with micturition, urine color, any urethral discharge, altered bladder control like urgency in urination or incontinence, menstruation and sexual activity. For diseases of nervous system, you should ask about headache, altered sensorium, loss of consciousness, dizziness and vertigo, speech and related functions like reading, writing skills and memory. For diseases of cranial nerve symptoms, vision, diplopia, facial numbness, deafness, oropharyngeal dysphagia, limb motor or sensory symptoms and loss of coordination. For diseases of endocrine system, you should ask about weight loss, polydipsia, polyuria, polyphagia and irritability. For diseases of musculoskeletal system, you should ask about any bone or joint pain accompanied by joint swelling or tenderness, aggravating and relieving factors for the pain and any positive family history for joint disease. And the last is for diseases of skin, you should ask about any skin rashes, recent change in cosmetics and the use of sunscreen creams when exposed to sun. Now, classification of anamnesis. First is pathological or clinical, second is philosophical or constitutional.
Now, first is pathological or clinical. In aphorism 3, 6, 14, 71, 83, and 104, Dr. Hahnemann said about diagnosis of disease or knowledge of disease. In aphorism 3, he said, physician must investigate what is to be cured in disease, knowledge of disease, indication. In aphorism 6, he said, all the perceptible signs and symptoms of disease represent the disease in its entirety. In aphorism 14, everything curably diseased makes itself known to the physician by signs and symptoms. In aphorism 71, in the 3 points necessary for curing, first is investigation of the disease. In aphorism 83, necessary for apprehending the picture of the disease. And in aphorism 104, utility of the picture of disease for the purpose of curing and progress of the treatment. For example, acute pancreatitis is an acute inflammation of the pancreas presenting clinically with acute abdomen. The onset of acute pancreatitis is sudden, occurring with abdominal pain, vomiting and collapse. Characteristically, there is elevation of serum amylase level within the first 24 hours and of serum lipase level after 3 to 4 days, the latter being more specific for pancreatic disease. And etiology for acute pancreatitis are alcoholism, cholelithiasis and trauma. Now, aconite napellus, on the basis of characteristic symptom of acute pancreatitis, pains are intolerable, they drive him crazy. And in belladonna, ambliration by standing or sitting erect. Now second, philosophical or constitutional part of anamnesis. In aphorism 5, 80, 205, footnote of 206, 260 and the chronic disease, Dr. Hahnemann said about actual cause of the disease, obstacle to cure and other circumstances of the appearance of the disease. He said in aphorism 5, attention to exciting and fundamental causes and other circumstances as helps to cure. In aphorism 80, psoriasis is by far the most important of the chronic miasm. It is the fundamental cause of countless forms of chronic disease. In aphorism 205 and the chronic disease, homeopathic physician treat the underlying miasm with the internal homeopathic remedies. Identify which chronic miasm are involved in the case. And the most important is footnote of aphorism 205, differentiating between actual cause of disease and occasions of the appearance. And in aphorism 260, remove any obstacles to cure, especially in cases of chronic disease. For example, in actual cause of disease, trauma or ERCP may cause acute pancreatitis. You can see here some underlying symptoms with violet in color. In Arnica montana, for the bad effects resulting from mechanical injuries and after injuries with blunt instruments, also present in symphytum. And in Bellis perennis, first remedy in injuries to the deeper tissues after major surgical work. Chronic pancreatitis or chronic relapsing pancreatitis is the progressive destruction of the pancreas due to repeated mild and subclinical attack of acute pancreatitis. Weight loss and jaundice are often associated. Later manifestations include associated diabetes mellitus and steatorrhea. Abdominal radiograph shows calcification in the region of pancreas and presence of pancreatic calculi in the ducts.
In relapsing condition of chronic pancreatitis, you can see here a violet color box with some symptoms in sulfur medicine in new and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advanced and complete. Complaints that are continually relapsing, patient seems to get almost well when the disease returns again and again. Now, role of history in anamnesis. It has three parts: past, personal and family. In past history, we should ask about vaccination, trauma, physical, mental or environmental, like burn, electric shock, etc. FNA, anesthesia or surgery, or non-surgical procedure like ERCP, severe disease or diseases, recurrence of severe disease or recurrence of severe diseases, any animal bite, suppression of disease or natural discharge, abuse, especially addiction, emotional, medicinal, hormonal therapy or self-abuse, etc. In personal history, you should ask about phase of conception, intrauterine phase, neonatal phase and milestone development, childhood diseases, puberty and menstruation, marriage and sexual life, pregnancy, labor, abortion and contraceptive pills, menopause and history of old age. In family history, you should ask about history of tuberculosis, cancer, tumor growth or calculi, hypertension or stroke, means CVA, diabetes or thyroid disorder, heart disease, means angina, liver disease, means cirrhosis or CA, gallbladder or liver, kidney disease, means CKD or chronic renal failure, and mental disease and allergies, etc. Now conclusion. Through observation skill of physician, correct interpretation, rational explanation to scientific construction, means anamnesis, Dr. Hahnemann mentioned about the necessary qualification of physician in homeopathic practice. And now you have seen that Dr. Hahnemann in the whole book Organon of Medicine has been told about the inductive method. Boninghassan, C. Herring, S.C. Allen, Boger, Bory, Clark, Dunham, Farrington, M.L. Tyler, Nash, N.M. Chaudhary, Fartek, etc. were also following Dr. Hahnemann's inductive method. And the major component of anamnesis is cryptogenic metastasis, which means development of diseases of unknown origin. Cryptogenic metastasis is the most important, unexplainable and neglected part of allied subjects whose understanding and importance is explained only in homeopathy. Now classification of cryptogenic metastasis, first is direct and another second is indirect metastasis. Now direct metastasis has three parts: physical, pathological and suppression, and indirect metastasis has miasmatic part. Now we are going on the first part, direct metastasis. First, physical part of direct metastasis. In causticum medicine, it has been mentioned as they never have been well since that burn, traumatic cause. Second, pathological cause of direct metastasis in pulsatilla medicine have never been well since anemia, chlorosis, bronchitis and phthisis. Third, suppression of direct metastasis in Thuja occidentalis medicine, suppressed gonorrhea causing articular rheumatism, prostatitis, psychosis, impotency, condylomata and many constitutional troubles. And now second, indirect metastasis, miasmatic part mentioned in Medorhinum medicine for serous carcinoma or cancer, either acute or chronic in development, when the symptoms correspond and a history of psychosis can be traced. Note, my objective is not to discredit any pathy or its physician. My objective is just to aware about the work limits of both pathy and where to take right medical treatment. For example, I am sharing a complete case of my mother, which was presented in short in the first part of this series. When she was suffering from non-pitting edema in both lower limbs, diagnosed by a super specialist allopathic physician, and after his advice, some important and related investigation had done, like 2D echo of heart, USG of abdomen, fibroscan and chest X-ray, kidney function test and thyroid profile, which were normal in reports with his prescribed medicinal treatment. But when there was no any improvement of that medication, I have given her Sambucus 30, then 200 and after then 1M with drastic improvement on the basis of the clinical indication of Sambucus, edematous swellings in various parts of the body, especially in legs, instep and feet. How anamnesis had helped me in this case, when clinical indication of Sambucus have given me direction for understanding of prognosis of pathology with their cause. Actually, she was suffering from paranoid schizophrenia, a psychiatric illness, since last 4 years, with acute severe complaint of retention of urine before 2 months of appearance of edema. And at that time, she got relieved by opium, 200 single dose on the basis of clinical indication of opium present in this book, as urine retained with bladder full. And while in opium, the secretion is not diminished, the bladder is full, but fullness is unrecognized, which were felt during clinical examination. And with frightful appearance of the patient, which has been mentioned as elements that originate from fright, bad effects of the fear still remaining. When I thought of Sambucus on the basis of clinical indication, relationship part of second prescription was strike in my mind, as Sambucus follows well after opium in bad effects of fright. And at that time I just remembered about her past history of fright in past life, and she has cured from both acute and chronic complaint, retention of urine, pedal edema and paranoid schizophrenia. These diseases did not recur in the last 1 year. If you pay attention, you will see that Herring's law of cure has been followed by nature in this treatment, from top to bottom, from head and abdomen to foot, after then cured by second prescription on the basis of Dr. Honeyman's inductive method and new and updated edition of Allen's keynote, Keynotes Advance and Complete. If you follow Dr. Honeyman's inductive method properly and read books related to this method, then you will be able to reach this level of prescription where it cannot be reached through repertorization. Thank you.
Hello friends, this is Dr. Rohit Gupta, author of new revised and updated edition of Allen's Keynote, Keynotes Advance and Complete, which is available online at amazon.in and offline at 9559096477. The first topic of this new series is importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. But before going to discuss on it, first we should go to its history and origin in medical science with relation to homeopathy.
To fully understand this series, watch this video till the end without skipping or forwarding it, so that you would not have any problem in understanding of any video in future. Now the first topic of this series, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. At first we must know what was the eligibility of stalwarts and the founder of homeopathy. After shortlisting of 20 renowned stalwarts along with founder of homeopathy Dr. Cephas Hahnemann, the figure showed that 90% of those were in the qualification of physician, means medicos, and the remaining 10% of them were non-medicos. Most of them were allopath, surgeon and homeopath, and they were following inductive method guided by Dr. Hahnemann. In the Genius of Homeopathy, Stuart Close said, analysis of the organon of Hahnemann as well as of the history of homeopathy and the life of its founder shows clearly that homeopathy is a product of inductive logic applied to the subject of medicine. It is in fact the first as well as one of the most brilliant examples of the application of the inductive method to the solution of one of the greatest problems of humanity, namely the treatment and cure of disease. But today we are following method of a non-medico blindly called deductive method without knowing history of his exact qualification. There is no doubt that he had also contributed in homeopathy, but changing the method from induction to deduction without complete knowledge of medical science caused so much damage to basics of homeopathy by distracting homeopaths from the right path. That's why medico stalwarts have used clinical and diagnostic medical terms and symptoms in their materia medica, whereas non-medico has used mental and repertorial approach, etc. Because of which we still stand 176 years back at 1814-3, when the last 6th edition of Organon of Medicine was completed even after guidance of Dr. Hahnemann. Modern medical science called allopathy had adopted and upgraded themselves and made largely acceptable so that it came into mainstream. But homeopaths have misinterpreted same thing in the Organon of Medicine and its philosophy with rigid and conservative culture of teaching that led to mushrooming of many new self-made methods in homeopathy. Dr. Hahnemann's inductive method in science is the application of the principle of inductive logic to scientific research. Inductive method leads complete symptoms in case taking. It requires exact observation, correct interpretation, rational explanation and scientific construction. According to homeopathy, there are two types of observation, clinical and simulimum. Clinical also have two subtypes, signs and symptoms, whereas simulimum contains characteristic rare and peculiar symptoms. General definition of observation, the action or process of closely observing or monitoring something or someone, or the active acquisition of information from a primary source. In living beings, observation employs the senses. In science, observation can also involve the recording of data via the use of scientific instrument. In living beings, observation in philosophical terms is the process of filtering sensory information through the thought process, and input is received via hearing, sight, smell, taste and touch, and then analyzed through either rational or irrational thought. In science, according to definition of Organon of Medicine, an instrument for acquiring knowledge is specifically a body of principles of scientific or philosophical investigation. Where does Dr. Hahnemann write about it in his book Organon of Medicine? I will tell the reference in the middle of the topic in all video of this series. In aphorism 6, he mentioned, all these perceptible signs represent the disease in its whole extent, that is, together they form the true and only conceivable portrait of the disease. It means all the perceptible signs and symptoms of disease represent the disease in its entirety. In diagnosis of disease, according to aphorism 14, he mentioned the accurately observing physicians by means of morbid signs and symptoms, an arrangement in perfect conformity with the infinite goodness of the well-wise preserver of human life. It means everything curably diseased makes itself known to that physician by signs and symptoms. Now, what signs and symptoms mean? Signs and symptoms are abnormalities that can indicate a potential medical condition, whereas a symptom is subjective, that is apparent only to the patient, for example, pain, fatigue, burning, etc. A sign is any objective evidence of disease that can be observed by other than patient, for example, a skin rash, lump, enlarged lymph nodes, abnormal pulse and temperature, etc. A clinical examination or medical examination or physical examination is the process by which a medical practitioner examines the body of a patient for any possible signs or symptoms of a medical condition through the use of observation by inspection, palpation, percussion, auscultation, etc. Note, the physical examination should yield 20% of the data necessary for patient diagnosis and management. In clinical examination, as currently used, was developed in the early 19th century as a method to evaluate symptoms in relation to recognized pathologies in order to facilitate diagnosis, management and treatment. Before the 19th century, the history and physical examination were nearly the only diagnostic tools the physician had, which explains why tactile skill and ingenious appreciation in the exam were so highly valued in the definition of what made for a good physician. Before 1895, the world had no radiography, but in 1879, C. Herring had mentioned hydrothorax, meteorism and tympanitis like medical words in his 10th volume of book Herring Guiding Symptoms before invention of radiography. And Dr. S. C. Allen had also mentioned same medical terminology in his last second edition of book Keynotes and Characteristics after clinical verification in 1899, which also called Allen's keynote. Indeed, people expect their doctor to examine them as a part of medical consultation. But after recommendation of Dr. Hahnemann in Organon of Medicine, it is the biggest mistake of homeopath is that many people do not think as doctor. So the physical examination is a time-honored technique in medical practice, and method of medical examination are described in Egyptian papyri, in the classical world of ancient Greece and Rome, and in Vedic medicine in India. Now, observation by physician through all his five senses according to allied subjects and materia medica. Abnormal pulse, abnormal temperature, enlargement of lymph nodes, enlargement of abdominal viscera, sensitiveness of diseased part, tenderness, edema, etc. by touch, cough, chest, pulmonary sound, heart sound, voice, etc. by hearing, taste of mouth and irritation by patient in taste, odor of breath, diseased part, discharge, etc. by smell, gesture and appearance, anemia, jaundice, carotid vein, abnormal gait, cyanosis, pigmentation, hemorrhagic spot, tremor, clubbing, some diseases, etc. by sight. And now I will tell the observation related to touch of physician by temperature and pulse. Here you can see some underlined symptoms, violet in color, which are signs and symptoms of the disease septicemia for diagnosis and treatment, which are written in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, Keynotes Advanced and Complete. chill severe general of bones and extremities, marking onset of septic fever, temperature 103 to 106, pulse rapid, small, wiry 140 to 170, cold clammy sweat in pyrogen. Similarly, the diagnosis of arrhythmia through signs and symptoms of pulse, full, irregular, very slow and weak, intermitting every third, fifth or seventh beat in diastasis. The diagnosis of cervical tubercular lymphadenopathy through signs and symptoms of stony heart, scrofulous or tubercular swelling of glands, especially lower jaw and throat in bromium. The diagnosis of hepatomegaly through signs and symptoms of pressing pain in liver, liver heart enlarged, aggravation by lying on right side in magmure. In sensitiveness of diseased part, extreme sensitiveness to touch in apis, belladonna and lachesis. The diagnosis of bowel obstruction or peritonitis through signs and symptoms of abdomen tender, distended, aggravation by least jar even of the bed in belladonna. Similarly, the diagnosis of pitting edema through signs and symptoms of dropsy from organic heart disease, from chronic liver disease, for advanced albuminuria following intermittent fever in leg diaphoretum. Similarly, the diagnosis of non-pitting edema, dropsy of lower extremities through signs and symptoms of edematous swelling in various parts of body, especially in legs, instep and feet in Sambucus nigra. Single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advanced and complete. For example, I am sharing a case of my mother when she was suffering from non-pitting edema in both lower limbs, diagnosed by a super specialist allopathic physician. After clinical examination and his advice, some important and related investigation like 2D echo of heart, USG of abdomen, fibroscan, chest X-ray, KFT and thyroid profile with his medicinal treatment. But when there was no any improvement of that medication, I have given her Sambucus 30, then 200, after then 1 mL with drastic improvement on the basis of the clinical indication, edematous swelling in various parts of the body, especially in legs, instep and feet. My objective is not to discredit any pathy or its physician. My objective is just to aware about the work limits of both pathy and where to take medical treatment. Thank you.
Second part of first topic, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. According to modern medical science and allied subjects, appropriate skills are needed to elicit the symptoms from the patient's description and clinical examinations. But new medical students and practitioners usually feel that history taking ought to be fairly simple, but clinical examination is full of pitfalls.
Importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice, part 2. This part is continuation of the previous part, and if you have not seen the last part, then link has been given below in the detail. Dr. Hahnemann has mentioned about the knowledge of disease indication in aphorism 3, qualification of physician in Organon of Medicine. This is the most important aphorism of the Organon of Medicine, in which Dr. Hahnemann had mentioned that what qualifications physician must have for doing successful homeopathic practice in classical way. Dr. Hahnemann said in aphorism 3, if the physician clearly perceives what is to be cured in diseases, that is to say in every individual case of disease, knowledge of disease indication. It means physician must investigate what is to be cured in disease, knowledge of disease indication. And in aphorism 71, he said, How is the physician to ascertain what is necessary to be known in order to cure the disease? It means in the 3 points necessary for curing, first is investigation of the disease. Now I will tell the observation related to the rest four senses of physician except touch, which are already discussed in last video. By sense of hearing, here you can see some underlined symptoms violet in color, which are signs and symptoms of disease. Paroxysmal cough. Cough paroxysms of 3 in sternumate and of 2 in mercurius. Similarly, the diagnosis of laryngotracheobronchitis through signs and symptoms of croup, anxious wheezing, aggravation during inspiration in spongia. The diagnosis of systolic murmur through signs and symptoms of systolic blowing at apex in spige area. The diagnosis of stammering through signs and symptoms of stammering or has to exert himself a long time before he can utter a word or makes great effort to speak in stramonium. Next is by sense of taste of the patient. In condition of dry mouth, signs and symptoms are bad taste in the morning in pulsatilla. The diagnosis of GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease, or acid reflux through signs and symptoms of eructations, sour, bitter after eating in nux vomica. Next is by sense of smell. The diagnosis of CA mouth through signs and symptoms of malignant affections of mouth, offensive foul breath in muriatic acid. In condition of infected wound, signs and symptoms are wounds old neglected offensive in calendula. The diagnosis of otitis media or perforated eardrum or excessive earwax through signs and symptoms of fish brain discharge from ear in tellurium. Next is by sense of sight. The diagnosis of anemia through signs and symptoms of red parts become white, face, lips, tongue and mucous membrane of mouth. The diagnosis of jaundice through signs and symptoms of fever, conjunctiva yellow or orange color in lachesis. The diagnosis of high blood pressure, palpitation with pulsation of carotid veins through signs and symptoms of violent palpitation with throbbing in carotids in glenoid. Similarly, the diagnosis of ataxia through signs and symptoms of lack of muscular coordination, muscles refuse to obey the will in gelsemium. The diagnosis of cyanosis through signs and symptoms of blueness of skin, eyelids, lips, tongue, cyanosis in distalis. Diagnosis of syphilis through signs and symptoms of eruption, dull red copper colored spots in syphilinum. The diagnosis purpura through signs and symptoms of petechia purpura hemorrhagica blue spots in sulfuric acid. Similarly, the diagnosis of neurocysticercosis through signs and symptoms of nervous diseases, twitching, convulsive trembling, catalepsy from worms in sabadilla. This is single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advance and complete. The diagnosis of Parkinson's disease through signs and symptoms of marked facial expression, short stepped gait, trembling of extremities, etc. as paralysis agitans in mercurius. This is also single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advance and complete. Paralysis agitans is the old medical terminology of Parkinson's disease. And like this, there are many old difficult medical terminology explained in dictionary part of this book. You can see here on right side. Similarly, the diagnosis of senile decrepitated through signs and symptoms of hearing, smell and sight begin to fail in embriagrasia. This is also single remedy in new revised and updated edition of Allen's keynote, Keynotes Advance and Complete. You can see here there are many underlying symptoms on right side. These symptoms are Dr. H.C. Allen's last work, which was published after his death but not included in current Allen's keynote. All these updates you can find only in this book. Thank you.
Today I am going to discuss on third part of first topic, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. During painful conditions, some special gesture of the patient have a classic site of pain and radiation, which guide us for diagnosis and their proper treatment, as well as the physical examination during observation of any consultation. The non-verbal communication is as important as what the patient says.
Importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice, part 3. This part is the continuation of the previous two part of this series. In aphorism 83, Dr. Hahnemann said, "This individualizing examination of a case of disease, for which I shall only give in this place general directions, of which the practitioner will bear in mind only what is applicable for each individual case, demands of the physician nothing but freedom from prejudice and sound senses, attention in observing and fidelity in tracing the picture of the disease. It means necessary for apprehending the picture of the disease. In considering the patient's general appearance, it is important to make a rapid assessment of the degree of illness. A history of weight gain or loss can be checked by observation, remembering that fluid retention will increase weight through edema. Obvious weight loss even when food intake has increased is a feature of thyrotoxicosis and diabetes mellitus. But psychogenic loss of appetite, usually affecting girls, causes extreme emaciation while physical activity remains unimpaired in anorexia nervosa. Through facial appearance, physician must need to observe the patient's face, the expression and particularly the eyes indicate real feelings better than words. The cheeks give information regarding the patient's health. They are pale in anemia and hypopituitarism. Generalized pallor may also occur in severe anemia. In case of mitral stenosis, there is sometimes a bright circumscribed flush over the malar bones, and in congestive heart failure, they may also be highly colored. In some cases of systemic lupus erythematosus, there is a red raised eruption on the bridge of the nose that extends on to the cheeks in a butterfly distribution. Telangiectasia, minute capillary tortuosity or navy, may be seen on the face in chronic liver disease. Cyanosis is a bluish color of the skin and mucous membrane on lips and tongue owing to the presence of reduced hemoglobin in the blood, feature of COPD or congestive heart disease. In atrophic glossitis, complete atrophy of lingual papillae seen in pernicious anemia or iron deficiency anemia. Now through color of skin, the pigmentation of Addison disease affect the buccal mucous membranes as well as exposed skin and parts subject to friction. In von Recklinghausen's disease, patches of cafe outlet pigment freckling of the axillae to large more than 5 cm in length areas on the limbs, trunk or face are a characteristic feature. By the observation of the hands of the patient, some classic appearance that should always be sought include finger clubbing in malignant diseases. Nail blade splinter hemorrhage. Most common cause is trauma to the nails. Colonoichia, which occurs in long standing iron deficiency anemia. Tremor should be assessed carefully, distinguishing between a rapid fine tremor due to thyrotoxicosis and flapping tremor of metabolic encephalopathy due to hepatic or renal or respiratory failure. Now through physical attitude of the patient. Severely ill patients slip down the bed or chair into uncomfortable attitudes. They are unable to correct in muriatic acid in new edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advance and complete. Patients with heart failure sit up because they may become dyspneic if they lie flat due to orthopnea. Patient with abdominal pain due to peritonitis lie still, whereas patient with colic are restless or may even roll about in futile attempt to find relief. Patient with painful joint diseases often have an attitude of helplessness like arthritis or rheumatoid arthritis or osteoarthritis. Now through the odor of the patient. The odor of alcohol is easily recognized in the breath, although patient may try and mask it in alcohol intoxication. The odor of sweet and sickly has been found in diabetic ketosis. The odor of ammonical or fishy is found in uremia, chronic kidney diseases. The odor of mousy in hepatic failure. Halitosis means bad breath is common in those patients whose poor dental hygiene and associated with chronic gingivitis. Now, particular gesture useful analyzing specific pain symptoms. Headache accompanied by preceding flashing lights, nausea and vomiting suggest migraine. A squeezing gesture to describe cardiac pain. Pain with hand position to describe renal colic. Rubbing the sternum to describe heartburn. Rubbing the buttock and thigh to describe sciatica. Arms clenched around the abdomen to describe midgut colic. Pain of subarachnoid hemorrhage is classically very sudden, like a hammer blow on the head. Myocardial ischemia is classically felt in the center of the chest. Peptic ulcer pain is classically worse when hungry and better after food. Pain from a hollow organ is classically colicky, such as biliary or renal or intestinal. Colicky right upper quadrant abdominal pain accompanied by obstructive jaundice suggests a gallstone obstructing the bile duct. Thank you.
On fourth part of first topic, importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice. A physical examination on clinical as well as homeopathic point of view requires a cooperative patient. Daylight is better than artificial light, which may mask changes in skin and mucous membrane color. Remember that physical examination starts from the moment you meet the patient during consultation. Every moment of your contact with the patient, every gesture and every communication is full of information.
Importance of observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice, part 4. In aphorism 104, Dr. Hahnemann said, when the totality of the symptoms that especially mark and distinguish the case of disease, or in other words, when the picture of the disease, whatever be its kind, is once accurately sketched, the most difficult part of the task is accomplished. It means utility of the picture of disease for the purpose of curing and progress of the treatment. According to homeopathy, there are two types of observation. First is clinical, which has already discussed in last three parts of this series, and second is simulimum, which also contains two subtypes. First is characteristic sign and second is characteristic symptoms. In aphorism 146 to 203, homeopathic treatment of disease part of Organon of Medicine, and in aphorism 153, Dr. Hahnemann said, in this search for a homeopathic specific remedy, that is to say, in this comparison of the collective symptoms of the natural disease with the list of symptoms of known medicines, in order to find among these an artificial morphic agent corresponding by similarity to the disease to be cured, the most striking, singular, uncommon and peculiar characteristic signs and symptoms of the case of disease are chiefly and most solely to be kept in view. Now, selection of remedies on the basis of expression, appearance and constitutional physical makeup of the patient. Expression by sight. The countenance is expressive of fear in aconitum napellus. Adapted to women of thin, scrawny, feeble cachectic appearance in sickle cornutum. Appearance by sight. Tongue white or yellow with red streak down the middle, or dry, moist, white or yellow coating or no coating on either side. Feels scalded in veratrum viridi. Constitutional physical makeup by sight. Body large and fat but legs too thin in ammonium muriaticum. Better adapted to thin and emaciated than to fleshy persons in lachesis. Some examples on selection of remedies by all five senses of physician. By sight, swallow with deep furrows looks older than he is in lycopodium. A yellow saddle across the upper part of the cheeks and nose in sepia. Children emaciated, unable to stand, slow in learning to walk, sunken flabby abdomen in calcarea phosphorica. Weakness and trembling of tongue, hands, legs of the entire body in gelsemium. Causes redness of face and eyes in belladonna. Now by smell, the urine has the odor of violets in terebinth. Wounds old, neglected, offensive in calendula. By hearing, sleep with stertorous breath in opium. Stammering makes great effort to speak in stramonium. Now by taste of the patient, irritation sour bitter in nux vomica. Heartburn sour belching, irritation taste and vomiting in macarb. Now by touch, parts cold to touch but not cold subjectively to patient in lidum pal. Heat of upper part of body, coldness of lower in arnica montana. Thank you.
Correct interpretation is as important as observational skill of physician in homeopathic practice for exact understanding of the cases. In correct interpretation, the observed facts needs analysis with understanding them in relation to each other and to their cause.
Importance of correct interpretation in homeopathic practice. Inductive method leads complete symptoms in case taking. It requires exact observation, correct interpretation, rational explanation and scientific construction means anamnesis. I have already discussed on its previous part, exact observation, in fourth part of video. Now I am going to on its second part, correct interpretation. Correct interpretation means understanding of observed facts with relation to each other and to their cause. Correct interpretation contains three part, cause, complaint and concomitant. According to cause, in introduction chapter of the Organon of Medicine, Dr. Hahnemann steps into say, for the first time in all history, remove the effects and you remove the disease, the cause of the effects, as written as ciset effectus, ciset causa. Cause is just like a trauma to the body which makes it ill after effect. It can be of many types, like environmental, physical, mental, or any severe disease itself, etc. Now, example of environmental cause. You can see a violet color box marked in Brania albumedicin. Complaints: warm weather sets in after cold days, or from cold drinks or ice sets in hot weather, or after taking cold or getting hot in summer, or from chilling when overheated kicks the covers off, or from exposure to draft cold wind, also present in aconite and hypersulf. Second example of physical, written in Arnica montana in violet color box. For the bad effects resulting from mechanical injuries, even if received years ago, and especially adapted to those who remain long impressed by even slight mechanical injuries. And mechanical injuries, especially with stupor from concussion, involuntary feces and urine, and after injuries with blunt instruments, also present in symphytum, and compound fractures and their profuse suppuration, also present in calendula, and concussions and contusions, results of shock or injury without laceration of sharp parts, prevent suppuration and septic conditions and promote absorption. Third example of mental, in Brania alba again, elements from chagrin, mortification, anger, also present in colocynth and staphysigria, violence with chillness and coldness, after anger chilly but with head hot and face red, also present in aurum mate. Fourth is example of any severe disease. In Carbo vegetabilis, we can see persons who have never fully recovered from the exhausting effects of some previous illness, or asthma dates from measles or pertussis of childhood, and has never recovered from effects of typhoid, also present in psoriasis. Now, second part after cause is complaint. Complaint is nothing but a disease of the human body. It may be acute or chronic or artificial chronic in nature, and every disease has its own sign and symptom for exact diagnosis, with concomitant symptoms for selection of similar remedy. For example, in Distalis purpuri, you can see here a violet color box with symptom: stools, very light ash colored or delayed chalky, also present in Chelidonium and Podophyllum, or almost white, also present in Calcarea and Cinchona, or pipe stem stool, involuntary, and all these symptoms are the feature of obstructive jaundice. Now, concomitant, third part. The uncommon, rare, peculiar, characteristic symptom is known as concomitant symptoms. It can be pathological condition, physical, mental, modality, and cause of the disease. Now we are going to step by step, one after another. Now, first, pathological concomitant. In Chelidonium majus, you can see violet color box with symptoms: constant pain under the lower and inner angle of right scapula, and some underlying violet color symptoms: slimy, light gray or bright yellowish diarrhea, face, forehead, nose, cheeks remarkably yellow, yellow gray color of the skin, wilted skin of the palms of hands, also available in sepia, hepatic diseases, jaundice, pain in right shoulder. All these symptoms are the feature of painful obstructive jaundice, and the box with symptom are the concomitant pathological condition. Second is physical concomitant. In Antimonium crudum, a thick milky white coating on the tongue, which is the red strand of the remedy, and longing for acids and pickles also. Now third is mental concomitant. In Pulsatilla, weeps easily, almost impossible to detail her ailments without weeping, and weeps when thanked in Lycopodium. Now fourth is modality concomitant. In Brania alba, one of the chief characteristics of Brania is aggravation from any motion and corresponding relief from absolute rest, either mental or physical. And fifth, concomitant of cause of the disease. In syncona, ailments from loss of vital fluids, especially hemorrhage, excessive lactation, diarrhea or suppuration, also present in syncona self. Now, correct interpretation is made of two parts, pathological and philosophical. In pathological condition, if the interpretation of the pathology will not be correct, diagnosis of the disease will also not be perfect, which is necessary for understanding of prognosis and case management of the disease. For example, in hypertrophy of heart, an increase in size and weight of the myocardium results from increased pressure load, while increased volume load due to most common cause of valvular incompetence. You can see here on right side the causes of the hypertrophy in left ventricular hypertrophy and right ventricular hypertrophy. Here you can see some underlying cause, and the most common cause are valvular diseases. In left ventricular hypertrophy, aortic stenosis and insufficiency, mitral insufficiency. And in right ventricular hypertrophy, pulmonary stenosis and insufficiency, mitral stenosis and or insufficiency. And left ventricular hypertrophy and failure of the left ventricle, also related to each other. And the medicine for this condition is nasatripudiense, simple hypertrophy of heart, for restoring a heart damage by acute inflammation or from relief of suffering of chronic hypertrophy and valvular lesions. Now second is philosophical. Similarly, if the interpretation of theory is not correct, then the right direction of treatment does not get in any case, because each case has variation in approach due to different angle of perception according to inductive method of Dr. Hahnemann. For example, in Medorhinum, for the constitutional effects of maltreated and suppressed gonorrhea, when the best selected remedy fails to relieve or permanently improve. And this constitutional symptom is the part of second prescription. Thank you.
Rational explanation and correct interpretation are two sides of the same coin. In this part of series, physician must know about the facts of rational explanation by referring them to their real cause and the law of inductive method according to Dr. Hahnemann.
Importance of rational explanation or intellectual or practical explanation in homeopathic practice. Inductive method leads complete symptoms in case taking. It requires exact observation, correct interpretation, rational explanation and scientific construction, means anamnesis. Now we are going on its third part, rational explanation. Rational explanation is an explanation that is logical with a large system of thought or referring facts to their real cause or law. Classification of rational explanation: one is philosophical and second is pathological. In philosophical, just like a seed of any type of plant like disease needs a special kind of fertile land to grow and become a tree, and that special kind of fertile land is hidden in past history of that disease. So importance of past history according to philosophy. The fundamental principle of homeopathy similius similibus curantur, which is a statement in equivalent terms of the Newton's third law, action and reaction are equal and opposite. It has four types: psychosomatic disorder, somatopsychic disorder, suppression of disease, and chronic miasms. First is psychosomatic disorder, when mental factors cause physical symptoms. In footnote of aphorism 222 in Organon of Medicine, it has been mentioned as it very rarely happens that a mental or emotional disease of long-standing seizes spontaneously for the internal dyschezia transfers itself again to the grosser corporeal organs. For example, a chest pain might be caused by stress, palpitation of heart might be caused by anxiety, but no physical disease is found. In staphysagria, you can see here a violet color box with some symptoms. Symptoms are: was insulted, being to be dignified, to fight, subdued his wrath, and went home sick, trembling and exhausted. It had been mentioned in new edition of Allen's keynote, Keynotes Advanced and Complete. Now second is somatopsychic disorder, when mental symptoms caused by bodily illness. In aphorism 224 in Organon of Medicine, it has been mentioned that if the mental disease be not quite developed, and if it be still somewhat doubtful whether it really arose from a corporeal affection. For example, altered mental functioning is a basic feature of myotonic dystrophy. And you can see in opium medicine, suppression of discharges like stool, urine, etc. causes encephalopathic condition. You can see here many symptoms are underlined with violet color, like all complaints with great sopor. Sopor is a Spanish word which means abnormally deep sleep. You can say it as coma. And next is sleep heavy, stupid, or with stertorous breathing, red face, eyes half closed, bloodshot, or skin covered with hot sweat, or after convulsions. Next is digestive organ inactive, peristaltic motion reversed or paralyzed, bowel seems closed. Again, next is constipation from inaction or paresis, no desire, urine retained with bladder full, paralysis of bladder or sphincter. And in opium, the secretion is not diminished, the bladder is full, but fullness is unrecognized. All these symptoms are related to each other in encephalopathic condition. Now third is suppression of disease, the development of secondary disease condition from suppressed condition of previous illness. The reference are mentioned in Organon of Medicine in preface 4th paragraph, in footnote 25th of introduction, aphorism 39, and in footnote of aphorism 285. For example, in Rastak, the dermatitis should never be treated by topical medicated applications, they only suppress, never cure. And fourth is chronic miasm. In aphorism 204 and 205 in Organon of Medicine, it has been mentioned as all chronic affections and diseases, properly so called, must be cured only from within by the homeopathic medicines appropriate for the miasm that lies at their root. For example, in tuberculinum, you can see here headache, chronic tubercular, again when the best selected remedy only palliates. Next is school girl's headache with a tubercular history. So nothing happens without a reason, it is the principle of nature. Now second part is pathological. In this condition, change of position, state or form, or the spread of disease producing agency from the initial site of disease to another part of the body. It's called metasquamatism or metastasis. It may occur as an adverse reaction to treatment of other disease condition called metastasis. In footnote of aphorism 205, mentioned as the basic malady is thereby not diminished in the slightest, the preserving vital force is therefore necessitated to transfer the field of operation of the great internal malady to some more important part, as it does in every case of metasquamatism, and the consequence is blindness, deafness, insanity, suffocative asthma, dropsy, apoplexy, and etc. For example, in colonsonia, after hurt is relieved, old piles reappear or suppressed menses return. And in pulsatilla, mumps, metastasis to mammae or testicle.
So diseases of unknown origin, so called idiopathic, have two type of causation, direct causation and indirect causation. In direct causation, metasquamatism, psychosomatic disorder, somatopsychic disorder, suppression of disease, and indirect cause in chronic miasm are the predominant. Now, importance of past history according to pathology. Rheumatic heart disease is a sequel of rheumatic fever in childhood, and marker for investigation is SO titer and 2D echo. Next is history of hepatitis B or C infection through blood transfusion or infected injection or STD, sexual transmitted diseases, or etc. may cause chronic liver disease. Marker for investigation is HBsAg or anti-HCV with raised HBDNA or scVRNA quantitative. Next is abuse of NSAIDs may cause chronic kidney disease. Marker for investigation is raised creatinine with scanty maturation. Now, adverse effects of vaccination. In Thuja, you can see here elements from bad effects of vaccination in bracket entemetat and Cilicia and Mizoram also. You can see here many vaccines with their adverse effect with reference of Park 20th edition. Acute flaccid paralysis, adverse effect by OPV vaccine, anaphylactoid reaction by all type of vaccine, anaphylaxis by all type of vaccine, arthralgia by rubella, MMR, brachial neuritis by tetanus, disseminated BCG infection by BCG vaccine, encephalopathy by measles and pertussis vaccine, fever by all type of vaccine, hypotonic hyporesponsive episode mainly by DTP vaccine, injection site abscess by all type of vaccine, lymphadenitis by BCG vaccine, osteititis or osteomyelitis by BCG vaccine, persistent inconsolable screaming by DTP and pertussis vaccine, seizures by all type of vaccines especially pertussis and measles, sepsis by all type of vaccines, adverse effects severe local reaction by all type of vaccine, thrombocytopenia by MMR vaccine, and toxic shock syndrome by all type of vaccine. Thank you.
I am going to discuss on fourth and last part of this series, scientific construction. It means analysis of the case. In scientific construction, physician must put the facts in coordination that the system we shall agree with the reality and similar choice of the remedy according to the law of inductive method. For example, which disease has occurred, in what order, and after what has happened, so that it can be eliminated by accessing the root of the disease.
Last and seventh part of this series, importance of scientific construction in homeopathic practice or anamnesis. Inductive method leads complete symptoms in case taking. It requires exact observation, correct interpretation, rational explanation, and scientific construction means anamnesis. In all these four qualifications of physician, you will automatically learn three more required qualifications, which include knowledge of disease, knowledge of medicine, and knowledge of application of medicine which have been mentioned in Aphorism 3 in Organon of Medicine. For better understanding of scientific construction, you should read it in Aphorism 83 to 104, case taking part of Organon of Medicine. The medical history or case history or anamnesis of a patient is information gained by a physician by asking questions either of the patient or of other people who know the person and can give suitable information with the aim of obtaining information useful in formulating a diagnosis and providing medical care to the patient. The information obtained in this way, together with the clinical examination, enables the physician to form a diagnosis and discover the remedy for constitutional treatment. The method by which doctors gather information about a patient's past and present medical condition in order to make informed clinical decision is called the history and physical. The history requires that a clinician be skilled in asking appropriate and relevant questions that can provide them with some insight as to what the patient may be experiencing. After all of the important history questions have been asked, a focused physical exam only involves what is relevant to the chief concern is usually done. Based on the information obtained from the history and physical, lab and imaging tests are ordered and medical or surgical treatment is administered as necessary. Systems are usually reviewed in a comprehensive history related to present complaint. For diseases of cardiovascular system, chest pain, dyspnea, ankle swelling and palpitation are the most important symptoms, and you can ask for a brief description for each of the positive symptoms. For diseases of respiratory system, cough, hemoptysis, epistaxis, wheezing, pain localized to the chest that might increase with inspiration or expiration. For diseases of gastrointestinal system, change in weight, flatulence, heartburn, dysphagia, hematemesis, melena, hematochezia, abdominal pain, vomiting and bowel habit. For diseases of genitourinary system, you should ask about frequency in urination, pain with micturition, urine color, any urethral discharge, altered bladder control like urgency in urination or incontinence, menstruation and sexual activity. For diseases of nervous system, you should ask about headache, altered sensorium, loss of consciousness, dizziness and vertigo, speech and related functions like reading, writing skills and memory. For diseases of cranial nerve symptoms, vision, diplopia, facial numbness, deafness, oropharyngeal dysphagia, limb motor or sensory symptoms and loss of coordination. For diseases of endocrine system, you should ask about weight loss, polydipsia, polyuria, polyphagia and irritability. For diseases of musculoskeletal system, you should ask about any bone or joint pain accompanied by joint swelling or tenderness, aggravating and relieving factors for the pain and any positive family history for joint disease. And the last is for diseases of skin, you should ask about any skin rash, recent change in cosmetics and the use of sunscreen creams when exposed to sun. Now, classification of anamnesis. First is pathological or clinical, second is philosophical or constitutional. Now, first is pathological or clinical. In Aphorism 3, 6, 14, 71, 83 and 104, Dr. Hahnemann said about diagnosis of disease or knowledge of disease. In Aphorism 3, he said, Physician must investigate what is to be cured in disease, knowledge of disease, indication. In aphorism 6, he said, all the perceptible signs and symptoms of disease represent the disease in its entirety. In aphorism 14, everything curably diseased makes itself known to the physician by signs and symptoms. In aphorism 71, in the 3 points necessary for curing, first is investigation of the disease. In aphorism 83, necessary for apprehending the picture of the disease. And in aphorism 104, utility of the picture of disease for the purpose of curing and progress of the treatment. For example, acute pancreatitis is an acute inflammation of the pancreas presenting clinically with acute abdomen. The onset of acute pancreatitis is sudden, occurring with abdominal pain, vomiting and collapse. Characteristically, there is elevation of serum amylase level within the first 24 hours and of serum lipase level after 3 to 4 days, the latter being more specific for pancreatic disease. And etiology for acute pancreatitis are alcoholism, cholelithiasis and trauma. Now, aconite napellus, on the basis of characteristic symptom of acute pancreatitis, pains are intolerable, they drive him crazy. And in belladonna, ambliration by standing or sitting erect. Now second, philosophical or constitutional part of anamnesis. In aphorism 580-205, footnote of 206, 260 and the chronic disease, Dr. Hahnemann said about actual cause of the disease, obstacle to cure and other circumstances of the appearance of the disease. He said in aphorism 5, attention to exciting and fundamental causes and other circumstances as helps to cure. In aphorism 80, psora is by far the most important of the chronic miasm. It is the fundamental cause of countless forms of chronic disease. In aphorism 205 and the chronic disease, homeopathic physicians treat the underlying miasm with the internal homeopathic remedies. Identify which chronic miasm are involved in the case. And the most important is footnote of aphorism 205, differentiating between actual cause of disease and occasions of the appearance. And in aphorism 260, remove any obstacles to cure, especially in cases of chronic disease. For example, in actual cause of disease, trauma or ERCP may cause acute pancreatitis. You can see here some underlying symptoms with violet in color. In Arnica montana, for the bad effects resulting from mechanical injuries and after injuries with blunt instruments, also present in symphytum. And in Bellisperinis, first remedy in injuries to the deeper tissues after major surgical work. Chronic pancreatitis or chronic relapsing pancreatitis is the progressive destruction of the pancreas due to repeated mild and subclinical attack of acute pancreatitis. Weight loss and jaundice are often associated. Later manifestation include associated diabetes mellitus and steatorrhea. Abdominal radiograph shows calcification in the region of pancreas and presence of pancreatic calculi in the ducts. In relapsing condition of chronic pancreatitis, you can see here a violet color box with some symptoms in sulfur medicine in new and updated edition of Allen's keynote, keynotes advanced and complete. Complaints that are continually relapsing, patient seems to get almost well when the disease returns again and again.
Now, role of history in anamnesis. It has three parts: past, personal, and family. In past history, we should ask about vaccination, trauma, physical, mental, or environmental, like burn, electric shock, etc. FNA, anesthesia, or surgery, or non-surgical procedure like ERCP, severe disease or diseases, recurrence of severe disease or recurrence of severe diseases, any animal bite, suppression of disease or natural discharge, abuse, especially addiction, emotional, medicinal, hormonal therapy or self-abuse, etc. In personal history, you should ask about phase of conception, intrauterine phase, neonatal phase and milestone development, childhood diseases, puberty and menstruation, marriage and sexual life, pregnancy, labor, abortion and contraceptive pills, menopause, and history of old age. In family history, you should ask about history of tuberculosis, cancer, tumor growth or calculi, hypertension or stroke, means CVA, diabetes or thyroid disorder, heart disease, means angina, liver disease, means cirrhosis or CA, gallbladder or liver, kidney disease, means CKD or chronic renal failure, and mental disease and allergies, etc. Now conclusion. Through observation skill of physician, correct interpretation, rational explanation to scientific construction, means anamnesis, Dr. Hahnemann mentioned about the necessary qualification of physician in homeopathic practice. And now you have seen that Dr. Hahnemann in the whole book Organon of Medicine has been told about the inductive method. Boninghassan, C. Herring, SCLN, Boger, Borey, Clark, Dunham, Farrington, ML Tyler, Nash, NM Chaudhary, Fartek, etc. were also following Dr. Hahnemann's inductive method. And the major component of anamnesis is cryptogenic metastasis, which means development of diseases of unknown origin. Cryptogenic metastasis is the most important, unexplainable and neglected part of allied subjects whose understanding and importance is explained only in homeopathy. Now classification of cryptogenic metastasis, first is direct and another second is indirect metastasis. Now direct metastasis has three parts: physical, pathological and suppression, and indirect metastasis has miasmatic part. Now we are going on the first part, direct metastasis. First, physical part of direct metastasis. In causticum medicine, it has been mentioned as they never have been well since that burn, traumatic cause. Second, pathological cause of direct metastasis in pulsatilla medicine have never been well since anemia, chlorosis, bronchitis and phthisis. Third, suppression of direct metastasis in Thuja occidentalis medicine, suppressed gonorrhea causing articular rheumatism, prostatitis, psychosis, impotency, condylomata and many constitutional troubles. And now second, indirect metastasis, miasmatic part, mentioned in Medoranum medicine for serous carcinoma or cancer, either acute or chronic in development, when the symptoms correspond and a history of psychosis can be traced. Note, my objective is not to discredit any pathy or its physician. My objective is just to aware about the work limits of both pathy and where to take right medical treatment.
For example, I am sharing a complete case of my mother, which was presented in short in the first part of this series. When she was suffering from non-pitting edema in both lower limbs, diagnosed by a super specialist allopathic physician, and after his advice, some important and related investigation had done, like 2D echo of heart, USG of abdomen, fibroscan and chest X-ray, kidney function test and thyroid profile, which were normal in reports with his prescribed medicinal treatment. But when there was no any improvement of that medication, I have given her Sambucus 30, then 200 and after then 1 mL with drastic improvement on the basis of the clinical indication of Sambucus, edematous swellings in various parts of the body, especially in legs, instep and feet. How anamnesis had helped me in this case, when clinical indication of Sambucus have given me direction for understanding of prognosis of pathology with their cause. Actually, she was suffering from paranoid schizophrenia, a psychiatric illness, since last 4 years, with acute severe complaint of retention of urine before 2 months of appearance of edema. And at that time, she got relieved by opium, 200 single dose on the basis of clinical indication of opium present in this book, as urine retained with bladder full. And while in opium, the secretion is not diminished, the bladder is full, but fullness is unrecognized, which were felt during clinical examination. And with frightful appearance of the patient, which has been mentioned as elements that originate from fright, bad effects of the fear still remaining. When I thought of Sambucus on the basis of clinical indication, relationship part of second prescription was struck in my mind, as Sambucus follows well after opium in bad effects of fright. And at that time I just remembered about her past history of fright in past life, and she has cured from both acute and chronic complaint, retention of urine, pedal edema and paranoid schizophrenia. These diseases did not recur in the last 1 year. If you pay attention, you will see that Herring's law of cure has been followed by nature in this treatment. From top to bottom, from head and abdomen to foot, after then cured. By second prescription, on the basis of Dr. Hahnemann's inductive method and new and updated edition of Allen's keynote, Keynotes Advance and Complete. If you follow Dr. Hahnemann's inductive method properly and read books related to this method, then you will be able to reach this level of prescription where it cannot be reached through repertorization. Thank you.